now since I've retired. I've been retired 6 years. I work for a large global company, and obviously we had all these same issues to deal with sickness and absence. And the company did lots and lots of things similar to what you've already done, supporting people in lots of areas. But the one thing that they did introduce, which did have a profound effect positively, was that they introduced a company doctor who worked alongside of employees and GPs, in as much as the doctor was only employed for half a day a week, came in on a Thursday, you know, I think it was. And if someone had long-term sickness or relatively poor record, the company doctor would see them, examine them, give his opinion, and he would work in connection with their own GP. But the company doctor would overrule the GP if need be. But it worked quite well, and the sickness levels did fall quite considerably. Is this something that the council do?
Through Chair, not quite the same model through the occupational health arrangements with access to a doctor. I think the difference is we're going to employ directly, haven't done for some years. I've worked in different organisations with kind of different mixed models really of that. And it brings its own issues because sometimes there can be downtime for a doctor that you're paying for when you don't need it. So in some ways the commission services are really easy to manage. But put along the same lines of making sure that employee needs to see a qualified occupational health physician, and it is also our position that the OH physician can override a GP if they feel like someone's fit enough to attend to work. So can we acknowledge what you're saying, and just the key differences we don't employ them directly.
As I said, the company I work for, they only employ that GP for half a day a week. So it was just a contract, basically. But when you look at the figures we're looking at, £3 or £4 million a year, obviously you can pay even the GP salary for half a day a week is not considerable when you look at what it's cost plus in the long term.
Can I say, we've had a good debate. We've been round the table. I think people have asked about 3, 4, maybe 5 questions from people, not looking at anything to the basis. And I think Tony has answered them to the best of his ability and answered them as thorough as he can. And thank you for that, Tony. Thank you very much indeed. Can I finish by saying, if committees agree, I've checked with a few people, that we have delegated to the chair and to the party spokesperson, the scrutiny officers, and Tony himself to possibly come back every 6 months if that's okay, with updates, because I think it's an important subject for all the right reasons. That's been expressed around the table by everybody. So if we can agree that committee, that's okay. Okay. And thank you, Tony. Appreciate it. Okay, the last, second to last. Rugby boiler with the city region.